Hello friends, in my this video I am going to discuss about a matrix related program in MATLAB, and the question is, write a code that when given an odd number produces an arrowhead function pointing to the right hand side. Okay, so what is that? Suppose you are giving n or input as 3, then your output or matrix would be like this, where see the pattern of the 1 is forming one pattern or arrow which is basically showing to the right hand side. All the other elements are 0. Like for suppose n equal to 5, then you just observe, see pattern of 1 is forming in the right hand side, alright, and all the other elements are 0. Like that you have to write the program. So what is the possible algorithm we can write? Okay, from the example, these two example itself, it is quite clear that the number of rows in the output matrix is equal to nothing but the input. Okay, like here see, here 5 is the input, so see obviously we are getting 5 rows, 1 2 3 4 5. Like here n is input is 3, we are getting 3 rows. Okay, but columns is getting deferred for different inputs. Okay, that's what we have to take care of in our algorithm. So you just observe each column elements. See the first column 1 0 0 0 and 1. Okay, you just observe the next column, just 2 ones which are basically initially at the two terminals of our column, just entering inside the column by one position. Okay, like see here, one was there, now it is entering inside the column element or in the central of the matrix by one value. So like that it is shifting. Again, in further case it is again shifting. Okay, so like this we have to write the code. So obviously very simple, what we'll do, we will put two counters, one for front end and one for rear end, and we will suppose a front end variable is k, we will define initialize k as 1 and l as the n value, which is basically input. Okay, because see l is basically here 1 2 3 4 5, which is nothing but input only, that is rear end is nothing but input only in the first case. Okay, then what we will do, if we'll take one for loop, basically we are going to create each columns, right? So in the for loop, we will take the for loop from starting from 1, because in MATLAB array index start from 1 to the end. Okay, that is end is basically the length of the basically number of rows in the output array, that is nothing but input. So for I equal to 1 colon input, if I equal to k or l, that is if the index is equal to the front or rear end counter, then we will put there once. For rest other case we will put 0, and we will do horizontal concatenation. Okay, so that what we will do, we will basically transpose our array generated by the for loop, and we will then add for concatenate z equal to z, a transpose. Basically we are going to transpose and then we are going to concatenate. All right so see, if you observe the code, then you will understand it more clearly. See here I have written the code, very simple, clc, clear all, close all. Obviously you have to write, you can write warning off also. Okay, then x equal to input, enter the number. All right then k equal to 1, l equal to x, k is basically variable for front end, l is for rear end. Okay, y one empty variable, which will basically store our output, a is basically one empty array, which is basically what will make or will form all the will form basically all the columns of our output matrix. Now see, what is the condition when we can finish our job, when we will stop executing that particular work. See, when k equal to l, why? Because if k is the front end index and l is the rear end index, then see, when k equal to l, when front end and rear end become same, then we can stop our execution. All right so here I have written, while k not equal to l, then inside this what we have written, see, for I equal to 1 colon x, that is input, if I equal to k or I equal to l, a of I equal to 1, else a of I equal to 0, as I have explained in my algorithm. In this if else, in this for loop, then you have to store like column wise. So transpose, don't forget to take transpose. So y equal to y a transpose, then increment the front end counter k equal to k plus 1, decrement the rear end counter l equal to l minus 1. Why? See here, k is 1. Okay, and in the next case k should be 2, so we are increasing the front end counter. But if you observe the rear end counter, l equal to basically in the first case it is 5, but next time it is getting 4. Okay, so we are basically, we have to decrease. So L equal to L minus 1, and again to store that, we are again defining A as one empty array. Otherwise, you will get error while concatenation, because A will obviously get bigger length if you don't initialize again in the next iteration as 0, and in this for loop, in this while loop. But up to this job is not done, because the while loop will only perform up to when k not equal to L, but we have to stop execution when k equal to L, right? So basically for that we have to execute one more time for I equal to 1 colon x. If I equal to k, that is, you can see if I equal to L also, because k equal to L does not matter what you give, I either I equal to k or I equal to L. A of I equal to 1, else A of I equal to 0, all right? In this if else, in this for loop, and again store that array horizontally. Okay, y equal to y a transpose. Let us check whether our code is working or not. So control A, then evaluate selection. Okay, so enter the number. Suppose let us give 3, and you enter, press y. See, here one array is created, which is basically nothing but one arrow of ones, which is basically pointing towards the right hand side. All right, then let us check for one more case. Suppose let me give 5. You write y and enter. See, here also it is forming. Okay, one more bigger value you can take, but that should be odd number. Like let me take 11. You write y and enter. See, here one pattern like this. Beautifully, it is able to arrange one matrix, which is basically pointing to the right hand side, formed by 1 and 0. Okay, I hope you have understood the algorithm. Try to understand it, because if you understand the algorithm, you can implement same program in Java, C, C++, Python, whatever your favorable language is. Just you have bit modify the syntax, and just little bit constraints, like for loop, if else, and all that, all those. Okay, I hope you have understood this. I'll post the same code in the description of this video. If you want, you can check there, and if you have any doubt, please ask in the comment section. Thank you for watching.